For weeks now, this rivalry's been brewing. At tonight's pay-per-view, this rivalry will come to a head.
WWE World Heavyweight Championship. Introducing the challenger from Baton Rouge, Louisiana, Marcus Smooth Thomas.
Well, this guy looks eager to add some gold around his waist. Let's see if he can do it. Settle for nothing short of a victory here tonight.
You know, this may be one of those rare occasions where the champ might actually be the underdog heading in. I don't remember a scene like this since JBL was champion.
I don't remember that.
Introducing the challenger from Miami, Florida, weighing in at 265 pounds, The Rock!
And the passion this crowd has for this superstar is truly amazing. Just listen to him.
Looking geared up and ready to go for this triple threat match.
So much anticipation. This is going to be one for the record books.
And here we go in this no-holds-barred, one-fall-to-a-finish match.
One of the most unpredictable forms of competition in WWE just kicked off. We have a packed house here, and there are personal issues everywhere you look.
This will be a physical battle.
You're right about that, Cole. This is going to be a war. This could be so physical that it gets really ugly before it's over.
The excitement in the air is palpable for this no-holds-barred contest.
Yeah, and that's because they know these competitors have free rein to do whatever they need to pick up the win.
Escape by Lesnar.
And it's moves like that that made Lesnar the one in 21-1. He's in big trouble.
What's he gonna do here? What's he gonna do here?
Camel clutch. He needs to figure out a way to get to his base and break the hold.
Thinking to avoid that.
When you talk about icons in this business, when you talk about moments frozen in time, it is hard to choose just one from The Rock's amazing resume. But when I think back to April 1st, 2012, WrestleMania 28 versus John Cena in The Rock's hometown of Miami, Florida, that was a moment for the ages.
Now, you know, Cole, I gotta tell you, there are so many to talk about, but the one that sticks with me more than any other is WrestleMania 18.
The save. The match continues.
What a punch!
You know, talking about incredible moments from The Rock's career, just sitting here and thinking of Rock's This Is Your Life on Raw, the Rock and Sock connection.
It was great.
I'm going WrestleMania 19, when for the third time, Stone Cold Steve Austin and The Rock headlined the show of shows, a rivalry, main eventing three WrestleManias that never happened before and will probably never happen again.
And somehow he's got to take the pressure off his neck.
Great move.
And it's The Rock with the reversal.
He's got him hooked. Gosh, Cole, you put us in a real tough spot here. Thanks. I don't think anyone but the great one himself can pick one historical moment that rests above all the rest. Heck, that's why he's the great one. The Rock turns it around.
God, there was nothing accurate about that attempt at offense.
Oh, you're being too kind. Some people would use other words to describe what we just witnessed.
He must be able to expand your chest in order to breathe.
I bet he feels like he's inside an anaconda. Uh-oh.
Doing a great job of avoiding any serious offense. That'll go a long way as this one progresses.
Too fast.
Thanks for tuning in. We're coming to you tonight from Santa Clara, the site of WrestleMania 31.
Oh, wait, nice reversal.
We're looking at complete domination here.
This might not end well. Man, there's no getting up from that.
And he breaks the three count.
Oh, I gotta tell you, I really thought that could have been it.
When his strikes land, you can feel it in the first few rows. Oh, what a save.
Yeah, that's what I call killing two birds with one stone.
You know, we talk so much about
shoulders down. Is it enough? And the referee's count is interrupted there.
Well, it just goes to show you that an attack can come from anywhere when you're in that ring.
That'll have you worrying about long-term injuries for sure.
There's some serious power right there.
I wonder just how widespread the back pain is. We'll find out soon enough.
No kidding. This is bad.
He's showing no signs of letting up. What? The sharpshooter! Rock's got him in the sharpshooter!
Man, oh man, did he take a wild swing with that one.
You're right. That was wild indeed. Good thing we're over here.
Speaking of some big moments, the one that I can't get out of my mind right now is March 28th, 1999. WrestleMania 15. That's right, the first of what would be three main events between the Texan. That's it. He's done.
That's called being driven straight down to the canvas. What power.
No kidding. That was an awesome slam.
Oh, wait. Nice reversal.
It's crucial to remember Brock Lesnar is not a regular man. He's merciless. He's a beast. He's a conqueror with the intent to dismember opponent.
And there's the triple German suplex. Brock Lesnar says enough is enough. He's going to end this thing.
And his opponent is about to take up residence in Suplex City.
It's been well.
Quick pin. Hey, is this
it? Oh, what a save.
Yeah, that's what I call killing two birds with one stone.
It's got to be hard to rebound from that one.
This could be big. Hey, now! He's just getting dissected. What a counter that was. Brock Lesnar with a nice reversal.
Again, these superstars are bound to absolutely no rules here in this disqualification match.
You know what, Cole? It's like the Wild West all over again.
They're still alive.
Yeah, Cole, you remember that song back in the day, Staying Alive? Well, that was it in WWE terms.
Michael, you talked before about Brock Lesnar and how not much is known about his private life. Well, let me tell you something. That's how Brock Lesnar wants it. And I wouldn't recommend anyone trying to convince him to change his policy. We know what we need to know. Brock Lesnar's been a beast in wrestling rings practically his entire life.
Quick thinking to avoid that.
Uh-oh. Uh-oh. He's in position, ready to strike.
Three of these competitors hoping to walk away with the Brock Lesnar. Wow, there's the save. The match continues. When you look at the private life of Brock Lesnar and the extent he goes to protect it, it's something that also helps him in the ring. How can you truly prepare for battle against someone if there's a point where you can't find anything else out about them? All we really know is his ability to eat, sleep, conquer, and repeat.
You know, Michael, that's a great point. I've never really looked at it that way. Lesnar's
shoulders down. Championship on the line.
Well, I don't know if you would categorize this as innovative offense, but it sure gets the job done. Just look at what's going on here. It is human destruction.
Oh, out of nowhere. Oh, that was a heavy shot.
And he fails to connect with anything that time.
Man, that was some miss, all right. I could feel the breeze all the way over here.
He's delivering an old-fashioned butt-kicking right here. Avoids the impact there. Now back to the ring.
Look out.
Oh, good grief. If he wasn't going to be able to sit before, he sure won't now. Oh, out here you have to be able to think on your feet lightning fast. One mistake, one moment of hesitation, and you can find yourself in a world of hurt. He's pulling out all the stops tonight. Uh-oh.
Nearly driven through the mat.
Oh, once you get out of the ring, anything can happen. You've got exposed steel, concrete, the barricades, and all of it can be used to cause massive damage.
This is what every competitor dreams of when they decide to get into this business, a match at the granddaddy of them all, WrestleMania. Looking at complete domination here.
Well, out here you have to be able to think on your feet lightning fast. One mistake, one moment of hesitation, and you could find yourself in a world of hurt. He's got a reversal.
Oh, no, here we go.
Oh, what a move from The Rock. Now, that's how you sweep an opponent under the carpet.
They're still alive.
Yeah, Cole, you remember that song back in the...
And the shoulder's up in time.
Well, as long as it's up before that three count, that's all that matters. I can't believe it. He just won't go away. Really pushing his opponent to the limit here.
Wow, what a reversal by Lesnar.
Yeah, I know they call him the Beast, but that was just beautiful.
Direct hit. Talk about getting tagged and knocked in the middle of neck.
Rock bottom hits. The SmackDown has been laid down.
His shoulders are down. And the shoulders up.
And the match continues. I love this. If that didn't slay the monster Brock Lesnar, nothing will.
Well, that messed him all right.
Hey, did you look before firing? What an idiot.
That'll have you worrying about long-term injuries for sure. And into the cover. And he breaks the three count.
Oh, I gotta tell you, I really thought that could have been it.
We've seen this before.
Yeah, I thought we were stuck on a rerun there for a minute. Oh, wait, nice reversal.
Look out.
Could this be it?
I think so. Force behind it.
Oh, what a shot. That did some serious damage. You can't take too many of those and expect to be in the match much longer.
Extra slow getting back to his base here. Shoulders down. Championship on the line.
Two, three.
He did it. The winner and your new champion.
There was no love lost in that match. And look at the impact in these highlights. Let's take a look at some of the big highlights. We may be looking at the match of the year. Oh, that was a match for the record books. The WWE Universe will be buzzing about this one for a while.
That's a big win for him, ladies and gentlemen.
The new champion.
There's nothing like WrestleMania. Good night, everybody.
Welcome back to the show. This is my guest tonight. Let's talk about what happened out there tonight. You are the new WWE Heavyweight Champion. How does it feel?
I am the champion. I still can't believe it. You know, I heard the crowd tonight. And it fired me up. It made me realize this is my moment. I belong here, and I should be the WWE champion. And I'll let the WWE universe know right now, I am keeping this championship for a really long time.
There you have it. Back to you guys.
Thank you.
is scheduled for football, making his way to the ring, accompanied by Cameron. From Baton Rouge, Louisiana, the WWE World Heavyweight Champion, Marcus Smooth Thomas.
Wow! The roof nearly blew off the arena for this superstar.
Looking ready to battle here on Monday Night.
And approaching the ring, from Winnipeg, Manitoba, Canada, weighing in at 227 pounds, Chris Jericho!
Oh boy, we're in for a treat tonight. Both of these superstars look geared up and ready to go.
Matches like this are the reason why Monday Night Raw is the most successful weekly show in the history of sports entertainment.
There's no other way to put it. This one-on-one match is going to be a struggle in every sense of the word. Neither man looks like they are remotely entertaining the idea of backing down. This is gonna be good.
Oh, out of nowhere!
That chop. Don't expect a lot of mercy to be shown here.
Yeah, none expected and none will be shown.
Chris Jericho grew up in Winnipeg, Canada, but was actually born in the United States in New York. His father was a member of the New York Rangers NHL hockey team. Jericho grew up idolizing WWE greats Ricky the Dragon Steamboat and Shawn Michaels and patterned himself after them once he decided to train with the Hearts in Calgary for a career in sports entertainment. What are your thoughts on Chris Jericho?
Jericho believes himself to be the epicenter of the WWE universe.
Yeah, Jericho might just have a slight God complex.
You think?
That's how you make an impact.
Wow, he's still down after that. Hey, what a move!
That wild strike found nothing but empty air that time.
Man, that's what you call swinging for the fences and missing.
Michael, you spoke before about Y2J's father and that he played for a few different NHL teams. Jericho has actually put on the Rangers jersey himself and played in the Rangers' annual celebrity charity game, which is held every year in Madison Square Garden, a place Jericho knows very well from our WWE event schedule.
Finding a groove here.
Jericho's personal life is fascinating.
when Y2J is not winning championships in WWE, as he likes to say, he's the lead singer of his heavy metal band, Fozzy. Jericho's love of performing also extends to Hollywood and comedy, where he's an alumni of the famous improv group known as the Groundlings.
Yeah, listen, Michael, no one ever said Chris Jericho is not a talented guy. Quite the contrary. I've seen Jericho play hockey, wrestle, and appear in Hollywood films like MacGruber. Jericho definitely is a man of many passions.
Man, oh man, did he take a wild swing with that one.
You're right. That was wild indeed. Good thing we're over here.
He may be in the best physical condition I've ever seen him in. Man, he might need to get a new identification photo taken after this one's over.
You're not kidding. After this one's over, his own mother won't recognize him. This might be it.
Today, too fast.
You have to wonder how much use of that arm he'll have as this match continues.
Quick thinking to avoid that.
And a quick kick.
No, wait, nice reversal.
Not today, too fast.
And that'll give you a negative attitude.
Going to the top, high risk.
Getting some air here.
I need some too after sitting next to you.
Here's the cover.
And he fails to connect with anything that time.
Man, that was some miss, all right. I can feel the breeze all the way over here.
If there's one thing an opponent of Chris Jericho's must do is set a strategy of ignoring Jericho's verbal attacks. You have to be able to avoid. Shoulders down, is it enough?
It may be. Two.
We're looking at complete domination here. And once again, we see a return to the specific maneuver. Hey, whatever works.
Yeah, if it keeps working, keep working.
Jericho maneuvers his way out of trouble.
Yeah, I didn't see that one coming, Cole.
Dangerous submission hold here. How much punishment can he absorb?
When someone is accomplished as Chris Jericho, there are countless things to combat against. The crucial first step is not allowing Jericho in your head. He'll shamelessly accost you with tirades, insults, and fabrications. But if an opponent wants to have a chance, they'll have to ignore all of it and focus on the match.
The end may be near.
Incredible! This has to be it.
Stay down! Stay down!
We could be seeing...
Ooh, nice counter!
My God, his body's been through hell, and his ribs have bore the brunt of the attack.
Man, I hope we can get a doctor out here as a precaution. Damaged ribs like that can make it hard to breathe. Not a lot of spring left in his step right now.
He's bleeding all over the place. This one's getting ugly.
Shoulders down. This could be it.
Count, ref, count.
These guys are giving it absolutely everything they've got.
They're not holding anything back, and I love it.
He's pressing all the right buttons now. High risk.
Look out below.
Look out. This should do it right there.
I think this is it.
Taking on some moderate offense here. Going to need to start playing a little better defense.
Nowhere to go. Oh, the longer he stays in this, the closer he is to losing the match.
Whoa! Would you look at this? Can you believe it? This is an undying will to succeed.
He needs to dig way down deep. deep if he wants to keep going now.
When this guy's on, look out.
Here we go. This could be it. The things this guy can do are simple.
Will this be it?
I think he's got it. For any opponent,
what a win. Man, he's got to feel great.
We all knew that Cena would be coming back for that title at some point, but he's staking his claim tonight.
Watch out. It's Seth Rollins. It looks like the Authority has his back against Cena tonight.
Welcome back to the show. This is my guest tonight. Let's talk about John Cena. John Cena just challenged you to a title match. Any thoughts?
Cena can have a title shot. That is, if he makes it to the pay-per-view. I'm going to make his life miserable for the next few weeks. He has no idea what he got himself into.
There you have it. Back to you guys.